A very good morning, dear students. Today we are going to learn in Inside the Atom what is meant by valency and electronic configuration. So last time we have already learned about what is meant by electronic configuration and how we can determine the electronic configuration using the formula which is given, that is 2n square in each of the shells, right? Now what is meant by valency? Let's begin first. Now valency is nothing but the combining capacity of an element, okay? So combining capacity of an element means nothing but when the chemical bonds are formed or when the chemical reaction takes place, the number of bonds which are formed is related to the valency. So valency is related to the number of chemical bonds formed by an atom. So that you are going to learn today, what is valency, right? Now valency generally remains constant in the compound. So if you take any compound, the valency of each of these compounds remains constant. There is also close relationship between valency as well as the electronic configuration. So atoms form chemical bonds by using electron from its outermost shell. Now how are these, you know, mostly compounds formed? So compounds are generally formed by the combination of two elements, okay, or two or more elements, and it depends upon how many electrons can be given or taken or shared, okay. And these electrons which are given, taken or shared depends upon how many number of electrons are there in the outermost shell. So this outermost shell, valency of an atom is determined by the number of electrons in the outermost orbit of an atom. So this outermost shell is also called as valence shell, and the number of electrons which are present in this outermost shell is also called as valence electrons. Now you could see there in that example there, different examples were given here, like calcium. So here you could see that the number of, okay, fine. So let's continue. Now helium, neon and argon are nothing but the inert gases. They are called as inert gases. Now you will understand why they are called as inert gases. Now if you see the helium atom, you find that it has only, its atomic number is 2, and therefore it has even 2 electrons, because you have learned last time that the atomic number is related to the number of protons, and number of protons are equal to number of electrons. So since atomic number is 2, it also has 2 protons, and so 2 electrons are there. So you can see 2 electrons in the helium atom. It is an inert gas. Fine. Now this helium atom, these 2 electrons are accommodated in the first shell, that is also called as the K shell. Fine. Now this K shell has the capacity that is 2, because of the formula 2n square, and it is also called as the outermost shell, because here only 2 electrons are there, and both these 2 electrons are accommodated in the first shell, therefore it is also called as the outermost shell. Fine. So these 2 electrons are present in the first shell, and you know, so it does not have any other shell, it does not require any other shell here. Okay, so why? Because it's electron, the number of electron the K shell has, and the maximum capacity of the K shell is 2, and these 2 electrons are accumulated in the K shell, that means it is completely filled. So since it is completely filled and it has only 2 electron, it is also called as a duplet. It is also called as a duplet. Okay, so helium has an electron duplet. Now next one is neon. So number of electrons are 10 here, 2 in the first shell, that is K shell, and 8 in the L shell. Okay, so the capacity of the L shell, as you know, according to the formula, that is 2n square is 2 into 2 square is 4 into 2, that is 8, and so this becomes the valence shell of neon. Now neon has an electron octet, that means this L shell which has, which neon has 8 electrons, and these 8 electrons, you know, accommodate in the L shell, which is the maximum capacity of the L shell, that is 8. Okay, so we say that neon has an octet. Now let us take an example of the third one, that is argon. Now the atomic number of argon is 18, so it has 2 electrons in K shell, 8 in the L shell and 8 again in the M shell. Fine. Now, so 2 electrons, as you know, are accommodated in the K shell, its maximum capacity, L shell has maximum capacity 8, and M has 18 capacity, that is 2 into 3 square, that is 9 into 2, that is 18. However, what happens in the case of argon, it has these electron octet, and you know, remember dear students, though the capacity of any shell might be more than 8, but we mostly consider either a duplet or an octet. Now in the case of hydrogen and helium, it is a duplet, whereas in the case of all other elements, we consider it as octet. So if the octet is complete, we say that the the valence shell is complete. Fine. Now here in this case, M shell, though it has a higher capacity to accommodate, since it has an octet, we say that it has a completely filled orbit. And since it has completely all these three atoms, if you see, all of them have their completely filled orbits. Helium, in the case of helium, it is the 2 electrons which is complete. So argon also has an electron octet. So helium, neon and argon, all of them are also called as inert gases. Helium has a duplet and neon and argon has an octet. Now you know that atoms of these elements do not combine with other elements. Now why is this so? It's because they are fully filled. Their shells are completely filled and therefore they need not take any electron from outside, neither they do give to other element. And since they cannot give or take or not even share the electrons, you know, they do not combine with any other element of any other atom of an element. Fine. And since they do not combine with any other element, they do not form compounds. Have you ever heard of any compound name called a helium chloride or neon bromide, anything like that? No. Now why? It's because they cannot combine with any other element, because they have a stable state, and every atom has to have attain a stable state. Now here all three of them have a stable state by having the completely filled outermost shell, that is the valence shell, and therefore they do not require to take any electron or give any electron or share any electron, and therefore they are called as inert gases. Inert means what? The meaning of the word inert means nothing but inactive. Why inactive? Because they do not form any compound. So they are chemically inert. Okay, so valency, and since they are inert or they do not give or take any electron, fine, we say that their valency is zero. Okay, remember this, student. So mostly inert gases only have the valency equal to zero because they do not form any compound. Now let us proceed a little further. Now let us take example. So valence is zero when the electron octet or duplet is complete. But most of the elements, if you see, elements other than inert gases do not have an electron octet. That means their outermost shell or the valence shell is incomplete. And to fill these, and in the case of hydrogen, it is the duplet. So electron duplet is incomplete in the case of hydrogen because it has only one electron. And that electron is accommodated in the K shell. So it requires one more electron to complete its duplet. So that is why we say that hydrogen has a duplet, whereas other elements have the presence of an octet. And they need to complete the octet. So to complete the octet, what they do? They combine with other elements. And when they combine with other elements, they form compounds. Fine. Now, if we see only inert gases, except inert gases, all the atoms of other elements have incomplete octet. Okay. Now, that means incomplete octet, that means they have non-zero valency. That means they have a valency other than zero. Okay. Only except inert gases, they have the presence of zero valency. That means they do not combine with any other element. Now let us consider the molecular formulae of the different compounds and let us know about their valency, like hydrogen. Let us take the examples of all these elements, that is hydrogen, chlorine, oxygen, okay, sulfur, nitrogen, carbon, bromine, iodine and sodium. Okay, so let us see now the compounds of all these elements and try to find out their valency. Now the formula of hydrogen molecule is H2, and therefore it has the valency, you know, you can see the valency of hydrogen is 1. Okay, so the two hydrogen atoms are combining to form a hydrogen molecule. So its molecular, the valency of hydrogen is 1. So two, both hydrogens, they are combining to form, so that is H2. Then molecular formula of HCl is H, so its valency of hydrogen is 1 and that of chlorine is also 1. So water, valency of hydrogen is 1 and that of oxygen is 2. Then hydrogen sulfide, valency of hydrogen is 1 and that of sulfur is 2. Then ammonia, valency of hydrogen is nitrogen is 3 and that of hydrogen is 1. Then that is methane, valency of carbon is 4 and that of hydrogen is 1. So valency of hydrogen bromide and sorry valency of hydrogen is 1 and that of bromine is also 1. Okay, so that is why the formula is HBr. Then next one, let us see next example. Hi, the valency of hydrogen is 1 and that of iodine is also 1. Then sodium hydride, valency of sodium is 1 and that of hydrogen is also 1. So in all these cases we could find that the hydrogen has a valency equal to 1. Whatever may be the compound it forms, the valency of hydrogen is always 1. Now hydrogen has one electron in its outermost shell, that is the K shell, and it requires one more electron to complete its duplet, like that of the helium. So helium has a duplet and therefore it is completely filled K shell, and since it is completely filled K shell, you find that the helium is a inert gas, whereas hydrogen is not a inert gas, and that is why since it requires one electron to complete its duplet, it forms the compound. Okay, so its electronic configuration is also 1 and its valency is also 1. Okay, next is sodium. So electronic configuration of sodium is 2, 8, 1. So that means 2 in the first shell, that is K shell, 8 in the second shell and 1 electron in the valence shell, that is the L shell here. Now therefore the valency of sodium is 1. Since it has 1 electron in the outermost shell, its valence is 1. Now from the formula NaCl, the valency of sodium is 1 and that of chlorine is also 1. Okay, now here you can see that sodium has 1 electron in the outermost shell, but in the case of chlorine, if you see there are 7 electrons, still its valence is 1. Now why is it so? It's because it requires 1 electron to complete its octet, whereas sodium has 1 extra electron in the outermost shell which it gives. Instead of taking 7 electron, it gives this 1 electron, and since it gives it 1 electron, its valence is also 1. Whereas chlorine accepts to complete the octet 1 electron, therefore its valence is 1. So you will understand this little later how the valency of some elements depends upon the number of electron, whereas some elements it depends upon how many electrons are required to complete its octet or maybe duplet. Okay, so depending upon these two things, valency is decided. So that means valence shell decides the valency of the different elements. Now in the case of sodium hydride also, if you see, the valency of sodium is 1 and that of hydrogen is also 1. Both of them have 1 electron in the outermost shell. Now hydrogen and sodium has the valency 1, so this means that the outermost shell, if it has electron number of the number of electrons in the outermost shell, determines the valency. Now let us take few examples here of the different elements, okay, and try to find out the valency of each of them. Now here you remember the last column which you see, that is 8 minus x, and second one is 4, x is greater than or equal to 4. Now here what is given here, suppose if x means the number of valence electrons, that means in the outermost shell whatever number of valence electrons, if they are equal to 4 or maybe less than 4, then we consider it as the same valency. Whereas if the number proceeds more than, if the number of valence electrons are more than 4, then we subtract it from 8, that is 8 minus 8. Why? Because it is the octet. Octet means 8 electrons in the outermost shell should be present. Suppose the number is 4 or more than 4, then we subtract and find out the valency of that particular element. Fine. Now here, if you now let us see the different examples here, the hydrochloric acid. So valency of the element and number of valence electron, how they are related to each other. Let us take the first example, that is hydrochloric acid. So here the valency of hydrogen is 1, and electronic configuration of the element is also 1, and the number of valence electrons are also 1, so that is why its valency is also 1. Second one is chlorine and hydrochloric acid. Its valency is 1, its electronic configuration is 2, 8, 7, and number of valence electrons are 7. Therefore the value of 8 minus x becomes 8 minus 7, that is equal to 1, as I have mentioned to you before. Next one is neon. No compound is formed here because it has 0 valency, and since it has complete octet, that is why it has it cannot combine with any other element to form a compound. Its electronic configuration is 2, 8, and the number of valence electrons are 8. So therefore 8 minus 8 becomes equal to 0, and therefore the valency is also 0, right? Next one is fluorine. In hydrogen fluoride, we have valency of fluorine is 1, and electronic configuration is 2, 7. Therefore number of valence electrons are 7, and 8 minus 7 becomes 1. So its valence is 1. So now sodium has, in sodium hydride has valency 1. The electronic configuration is 2, 8, 1, and the number of valence electrons here are 1. Therefore its valence is also 1. Now magnesium is magnesium chloride. In magnesium chloride, magnesium valency is 2. You can see Cl2 is there. So that means valency is 2. Number of valence electrons, the electronic configuration of magnesium is 2, 8, 2. So therefore it has 2 electrons in the valence shell. Fine, number of valence electrons are 2, so valence is 2. Then in methane, carbon has valence equal to 4. Why? Because its electronic configuration is 2, 4. So number of valence electrons here are 4, and therefore 8 minus x, value of 8 minus x becomes 8 minus 4 is equal to 4. Then in aluminium chloride, the valence of aluminium is 3. You can see Cl3, so 3. Therefore, its electronic configuration is 2, 8, 3. Fine. And the number of valence electrons here are 3. Therefore, 8 minus 3 becomes, 8 minus, okay, fine. So, 3. Now, here we can see that there is a relationship between the number of valence electrons. Okay, now here you could see that the number of valence electron of certain elements like chlorine, neon and fluorine, okay, hydrogen, sodium, magnesium, carbon and aluminium, if you see, whatever are the number of valence electrons, same is their valency. Correct. That is, a hydrogen is 1, valency of the number of valence electron is 1, valency is also 1. Then sodium, number of valence electrons is 1 and its valency is also 1. Magnesium, number of valence electrons are 2, its valency is also 2. Carbon is 4, valency is also 4, and aluminium is 3, valency is also 3. Correct. So you can say that the number of valence electrons in certain elements is same as that of the valency. Whereas in certain other elements, if you see, the number of valence electrons are, you know, different from the valency. But how you can find out? You can find out because the number is more than 4. And 4 or more than 4. So we have to use here 8 minus x, or 8 minus the number of valence electrons here. Why? Because they require that many electrons to complete their octet. So those many electrons to complete the whatever number of electrons they are getting, taking, that is their valency. So here you can see that 8 minus 7 is equal to 1. That means it requires one electron to complete its octet. So it takes that one electron, and therefore it has the valency equal to 1. Fine. So number of valence electrons and the value of the this related to the valency of the element. So in all these, from these we can understand whatever is the value of the okay, that means they are requiring that many electrons. From this value of 8 minus x, which tells you that they require that many electrons to complete their octet. In the case of chlorine, if you see, the outermost shell has 7 electrons and it requires 1 electron. So 8 minus 7 is 1, so its valency becomes 1. Now in the case of fluorine, you could see that it has 2,7, that means required 2 electrons to complete its octet, and therefore its valency is 2. That is 8 minus 6 becomes 2. The next one is carbon. It requires, you know, it has 4 electrons, okay, and it requires 4 electrons to complete its octet. Therefore, 8 minus 4 becomes 4, and therefore its valence is also 4. So from this formula, we can come to know that 8 minus, you know, when we are subtracting from an octet, what is their valency? Fine. Now, next. So from these, what we can conclude is that two things. Okay, one is the valency of the element and electronic configuration are related to each other. Now always remember from this, the valency of an element is same as the number of its valence electron if this number is 4 or less than 4. Okay, 4 or less than 4. Whereas when an element has 4 or more valence electrons, the number of electrons by which the octet is short of completion is the valency of that element. Okay, fine. Now, next one, let us take now few examples here and find out, you know, let us try to answer the questions which are given on your textbook. Use your brain power. First one is, what is meant by atomic number of an element? We have already found out this. Atomic number of element is number of protons, as previously you have learned. And number of electrons are also equal to number of protons. So, number of electrons in the outermost shell of helium is, you know, let us try to find out now the next thing, that is next question, that is atomic numbers of some elements are given here. You can see in the first row the atomic numbers are given there, and you need to find out, write down the number of electron present in the outermost shell of each atom. So can you do this? Yes, it's very easy, because you know atomic number is number of protons, and number of protons is also equal to number of electrons. So therefore, whatever is the atomic number, same will be its number of electrons. So in the case of hydrogen, it has one atomic number, and therefore the number of electrons in the outermost shell, it has the number of electrons is 1. Okay, in the outermost shell, sorry. Next one is carbon, and carbon outermost shell, carbon has atomic number 6. So in the number of electrons in the outermost shell, you know, first case shell, it requires 2 electrons to complete its duplet, and other 4 which are remaining now, 2 plus 4, right, that is equal to 6. So 4 goes in the outermost shell. So the number of electrons in the outermost shell is equal to 4. Fine. Now, in the case of sodium, the number of atomic number is 11. So, the K shell has 2 electrons and 2 electrons, whereas L shell has 8 electrons, and the 1 electron which is left goes, so 8 plus 2 is equal to 10, and 1 which remains, it goes in the outermost shell. So, outermost shell has 1 electron in the case of sodium. Whereas chlorine, if you see, chlorine has 17 atomic numbers. So, it's 2, 8 and 7. So last shell has 7 electrons, so 7 electrons in the outermost shell. Nitrogen has 7 its atomic number, so 5 electrons are there in the outermost shell. Let us try to answer the next question. So if the number of electrons are given, can we determine the electronic configuration, number of valence electrons and the valence of the element? Yes, of course, my dear students, if the number of electrons are given, we can find out all these things. Fine, because you have to know now the formula, that is 2n square, how many how many electrons are accommodated in each shell. By knowing the number n means nothing but the number of shell, 1, 2, 3, 4, and accordingly we can find out the electronic configuration. Also, how many number of valence electrons are there and what is the valency. Just now we have learnt about the valency. So it's very easy to answer. Now let us take few examples here. Now lithium has electronic configuration 3, so the number of electrons are equal to 3. So the electronic configuration becomes 2 and then 1 is remaining, so 2, 1. So number of valence electrons is 1 and valence is also 1, correct? Now the next one is carbon. So carbon is atomic number 6, so the number of electrons are 6. So its electronic configuration is 2, 4, right? The number of valence electrons becomes 4 and valency is also 4. Okay, now magnesium has 12 as its atomic number, so the number of electrons are 12. Electronic configuration is 2, 8 and 2, and a number of valence electrons are 2 and its valency is also 2. Whereas oxygen atom has atomic number 8, so it has 8 electrons in out 8 electrons altogether. Electronic configuration become 2, 6. It requires 2 electrons to complete its octet, so 6 is the number of valence electrons and 2 becomes the valence fine. Now let us take now few more examples. The number of electrons of some element are given here. So have you wondered why the atomic number and the atomic mass numbers are whole numbers? Yes, always we are saying that atomic number of carbon is 6 and atomic mass number is 12. So why are they whole numbers? Why they cannot be 12.4 or so? Why? Let us see now. You know that atomic number and atomic mass numbers, why are they whole numbers? It's because the atomic number is the number of protons or maybe the electrons which are present, whereas atomic mass number is number of protons and the number of neutrons, and they cannot be other than less than whole numbers, and therefore they are always they cannot be in decimal. Proton cannot be a cut one half proton or maybe 1/4 proton. So that is why we cannot have a decimal fraction here. There should be always the whole numbers. Now next last question, that is of this topic. Sulfur contains 16 protons and 16 neutrons. Fine. So what would be its atomic number and atomic mass number? Very easy. The number of protons tells you that it is the atomic number. Fine, so here 16 is there, therefore its number of protons is equal to 16. And atomic mass number is number of protons plus number of neutrons, and that is equal to 16 plus 16 is equal to 32. Fine, so this is regarding your chapter, this is regarding the valency and the electronic configuration. So next time we are going to learn about what is meant by what are isotopes. So till then, students, bye and thank you. If you have any doubt regarding this topic, okay, which I have just now taught, you can write to me in the comment. Fine, so thank you till then, students, bye.